Thank you so very much, and welcome once again to Georgia Championship Wrestling, and what a program we have in store for you. A lot of great action upcoming. We'll tell you more about that in just a couple of moments, and more about the most popular wrestler contest, all of that coming up. But right now, more important things on my mind and the mind of the gentleman right to my left. I'm referring, of course, to two times World Heavyweight Wrestling Champion, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Welcome aboard, Dusty.
It's opportunity to be on this superstation, be on this super place to talk about something that's very, very close to me. You know, I offer up this thing right here, this World Heavyweight title belt. I offer it up to the Ernie Lairds, to the Ric Flairs, to the Harley Races, to the many men throughout this country that have a dream of being World Heavyweight Champion. Dusty Rhodes, the World Heavyweight Wrestling Champion. At any time, you know I can be beat. But you know it's going to take a lot of men to beat Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream. So I'm offering it up to you. I'm laying it out to you, the mass superstars, the Ernie Lairds, the Ric Flairs, the Kerr Von Erichs, the Tommy Richards, and the Harley Races, six times World Heavyweight Champion, the American Dream, the Cosmic Cowboy, the last surviving hero in this country, has the goal. If any of them want it, all they got to do is play my song, and I'll take that pinch between my cheek and gum out, and I'll get in that ring, and I'll do some battle jack like they never seen done in the history of pro wrestling, because I am truly proud of this thing here, God.
And he certainly has every right to be, too. I might just say that Dusty Rhodes, of course, I think epitomizes what every professional athlete would like to be. And that, of course, is the very, very finest in his profession. And certainly he is at this point in time. During the next hour, we're going to be seeing George Wells and Steve O in action. We'll be watching Harley Race, who was six times World Heavyweight Champion. He is, and of course, is looking to regain that heavyweight title. Also, the superstar, Ernie the Cat Ladd, and many, many more coming up. Before we get to our first match, however, I would like to remind you, this is your final week to send in your vote for the most popular wrestler. This is your final week, and we suggest that you send this in by postcard only. Now, we've gotten a lot of letters, and unfortunately, with our staff, it is a little impossible to worry about trying to get into all of those letters. So please send your votes by postcard only. You may send it to Georgia Championship Wrestling, 100 Techwood Drive Northwest, Atlanta, Georgia, 30303. By all means, do send it in. This is the final week, and we will be announcing the winner of the most popular wrestler contest next week here on Georgia Championship Wrestling. So by all means, do stay tuned for that. That'll be some exciting news, I am sure. We have our first match coming up, and we'll have that right after we have our ring introductions and a special message.
Ladies and gentlemen, this tag team event, one fall with a 10-minute time limit, one fall 10, from Burlington, North Carolina, 285 pounds. Here's Dave Forrester. Dave Forrester. His team partner from Israel at 230 pounds, Izzy Slapowitz. Izzy Slapowitz. Their opponents from Edina, Minnesota at 235 pounds. Say hello to Steve O. Steve O. His team partner from Oakland, California, 247 pounds, Big George Wells. George Wells, the referee's George Scott Jr., back with this match after this brief timeout.
There's the bell, one fall, 10-minute time limit. Izzy Slapowitz and Dave Forrester going up against George Wells and Steve-O, and that's Slapowitz out of Israel. Moving against George Wells. George Wells out of Oakland, California. Wells, tremendous athletic and academic background. Wells, duck under, go behind, full Nelson, reversal to a snapmare. And Slapowitz beginning to feel the pressure of a man like George Wells. Side headlock by Wells, makes the tag with Steve-O. Steve-O, hip lock takedown, keeps the side headlock. Steve-O, 6'1", hits the scales of between 225 and 230. Steve's 28 years old. Born in Charlotte, North Carolina, but raised in Edina, Minnesota. Went through high school there at Edina High, then went on to college at Gustavus Adolphus. Has his B.A. in teaching. His dad, of course, a former great football player with the Green Bay Packers. Steve-O breaks it up with Slapowitz. Steve-O leapfrogs over his man, right back into a hip lock takedown. Tag is made with George Wells. Slapowitz tags up with Dave Forrester. Forrester, 6'2", 285 pounds. He's a big fellow. He's been wrestling in the pro ranks for the past 5 years. Good reversal by Wells now to a top wrist lock. Wells. Arm whipped into the turnbuckle. Swings out of the way, up and over the top rope. Caught him. Used the flat of the foot. Dropped Forrester off his feet. Forrester went to college at Tech of Alamance. Steve-O back in there against Forrester. Caught him in the pit of the stomach. Steve-O. Full body slam. Steve-O using that knee very effectively. Steve-O, top armbar on Forrester, reverses that now, or takes it down to a full arm drag and twist, makes the tag with Wells once again. Forrester whipped off the ropes, caught by Wells. Forrester powered out before the count of three, however, and Forrester caught that time by Wells, a good forearm to the side of the jaw. Wells, open hand into the chest. Inside cradle by Steve-O, but Forrester into the ropes. By the way, Forrester, in high school and college, football, wrestling track, softball, and tennis. And we're beginning to see why, of course, tennis gave him a lot, gives him a lot more ground speed for a man his size. He was with the state 3A football championship team in 1972. Slapowitz back in there now from Israel. Slapowitz using that right hand to the chest and to the midsection of Steve-O. Slapowitz, a double sledge to the back of the head, to the back of the back once again. Slapowitz. As Steve-O, and now double teaming on Steve-O by Forrester and Slapowitz. Again, the tag is made. Forrester taking some extra leverage by being outside the ring ropes, using those ring ropes to his own advantage. Steve-O fires to the midsection. Forrester, a forearm across the back. Steve-O again to the midsection. Forearm across the back. That caught him right around the heart. No, sir. Came out before the count of three. Wells uses that reverse type kick very effective. Wow. What a forearm that time that rocked Forrester. Now a knee lift into the chest that has Forrester to the canvas. Lateral press. Forrester still with great upper body strength. Great desire still. Was able to power out before the count of three. And again, Forrester pulled that shoulder off. All right, George Wells keeping the side headlock. Forrester now has to be... Forrester. ripping across the eyes that time, back to his feet. Uses the back of the elbow very effectively. Wells catches him over the ear that time. Steve-O, arm whip, the solid right hand to the midsection. Steve-O closes in on his man again. Forrester very slow, coming back to his feet. Forrester bulls him back, used that 285 pounds to his own advantage. Bulls him back into his own corner, and Slapowitz, taking advantage of that situation, tags up. And Slapowitz using the back of the elbow. Marshall Nelson that time, and it is Forrester now with the side headlock on Steve-O. Steve-O trying to keep him trapped. Wells made the tag. Wells had about 5 years in the Canadian Football League. Steve-O on that top rope. Count of three. A count of three. Steve-O. And George Wells getting the pinfall victory over the combination of Mr. Forrester and Mr. Slapowitz. Right now, I want to take a moment to talk to a gentleman who certainly needs no introduction to wrestling fans the entire world over. I'm referring, of course, to the great Mephisto. Here is a man who, along with being an outstanding competitor in the pro ranks for a number of years, has developed an uncanny knack for discovering some of the toughest wrestling competitors in the world. And he has brought us a new man now in Tara Kamata.
Tara Kamata. You know, Gordon and Soleil, there have been a lot of unusual talent that has came into professional wrestling. And as you have known, I have managed the most outstanding, the most fierce fighting competitors that wrestling has ever had to offer. But the most outstanding wrestler that I have ever managed in my entire length of time of management is Tara Kamata. 365 pounds of mental and muscular coordination. This man is a human destruction machine. Now let me give you just a little background of Tara Kamata. He was born in Nagasaki, Japan, in the war-torn city. The sins of mankind were written across Nagasaki, which grieved Kamata. Kamata then, at a very, very early age, started to study Buddhism and became, after 14 years of meditation, a Buddhist monk. He is an ordained Buddhist monk. But let this not fool the competitors. This man is an astute student of karate, kung fu, catch-as-catch-kin, any form of fighting, any form of martial arts. And he has one destination, and that is to rid wrestling of all the evil spirits. As you know, a man has to go with his karma. And Tara Kamata reincarnated many, many times. And now this time, he has been reincarnated back into the fierce competitor that he is. And you'll see much more of him.
Thank you so very much, the great Mephisto and Tara Kamata. We'll be back in just a moment. I want to take a moment right now to talk to both Kevin Von Erich and Michael Hayes, two outstanding competitors. Of course, Kevin Von Erich, a second-generation wrestler, and at the opening of the program, I was talking to the world heavyweight champion, Dusty Rhodes, and one of the names of potential challengers for that title happens to be yours.
Well, I'm shooting for any belt I can. I've held some of the most prestigious belts around, not to be bragging, folks, but I've been working real hard, and it's paid off for me. I held the National Heavyweight Championship that I'm really proud of. I won that in Fort Worth, and then I won the Missouri belt and some other belts that I've really been proud to own. But the big belt, the Dusty Rhodes belt, I feel like I've come of age now. I've worked hard, and I'm ready.
Well, you can hear the music.
Brother, how you doing, baby?
The original Fabulous Freebird is here.
I got a package, baby. I got a package, and you know who it's for. It's got to be the one, the only Baby Hewitt. Feast your eyes, that is. That's right, the Baby Hewitt. I got exactly something to take care of you tonight. You understand? Because tonight is the night. Saturday night is a good night for partying. And we're going to party tonight in the Omni. You understand? You know, I've held a lot of tag team championships with a lot of people. And I can't say that this really means that much to me, except you hold that belt and it means something to you, and I want it. And I've got a partner that's going to help me get it. Because tonight, we're going to take his bread and butter and nut and udder. Because we're going to strut, we're going to stroll, we're going to rock, we're going to roll with them belts, baby.
This is my night, and I'm not going to let my partner down. I was jumped from behind, and I'm going to show you what size boot these are. I'm the size of that big, fat, ugly face of yours, Gordy. You watch me.
Well, of course, that Georgia Tag Team Championship on the line, and it'll be Terry Gordy and Sam.
If I get him down, baby, I'm going to wrap one of these right around his hiney and let him be just what he is, a big Baby Huey.
Plenty of good seats still available at the Omni
tonight.
For the matches tonight, at 8:30.
In the Omni. Tonight.
Thor Kamada, managed by the great Mephisto, entering the ring right now, and Kamada catching Deke Rivers before Rivers. He was had his attention drawn by the Freebird, Michael Hayes, and Kevin Von Erich. And so it is Kamada. And he is a massive individual. Kamada smashing Deke Rivers into that turnbuckle once again. And Kamada, Deke Rivers fires to that midsection, fires again. And that had the effect of a mosquito. Not even a minor irritant on Kamada. Kamada totally dominating the situation here. A chop into the throat that spun Rivers completely around, drove him back to the canvas. Mephisto, of course, with a reputation of being a brilliant manager, but also with a reputation of not allowing... And you see, Mephisto using physical and obviously emotional and mental force to control this man, Kamada. Kamada was born in Nagasaki, Japan. Interesting background on this man. And Rivers... completely at the mercy of Kamada. And it was... All right, Rivers in trouble. Rivers in a lot of trouble now as Kamada has totally dominated this situation. And Rivers, who probably because of his experience has not had an opportunity to face too many of the Japanese competitors and not realizing the philosophical attitude. And Kamada apparently is having his problems understanding. Must have thought that he had demolished his opponent. Rivers back on his feet, and Kamada, seemingly totally impervious to pain of any kind, uses that chop very effectively. And Rivers has tried just about everything and has had no effect whatsoever on Kamada. You can see in and out of the picture on your screen. There you see it, the figure of the great Mephisto. And Kamada using a cravat, utilizing the ring ropes as well. 300 and some odd pounds into the air. Beautiful flying drop kick. Then crashing down his full weight, down upon the body, and now Kamata. And Mephisto in there very quickly to bring this situation to a halt. And so Kamata has an obvious language problem here. Also a problem in understanding the American catch-as-catch-can rules. The only problem he doesn't have is how to devastate an opponent, because we saw him do that very, very handily indeed. I want to take a moment to remind you once again, of course, this is the final week for your vote as the most popular wrestler contest. We certainly hope that you will send in your vote. We're getting a tremendous response on this. Please send it in by postcard and only. You may send that to Georgia Championship Wrestling, care of Techwood Drive Northwest. That's 100 Techwood Drive Northwest, Atlanta, Georgia, 30303. And now, let's take a look at wrestling around the country. Here's Freddie Miller.
Thanks, Gordon. Great wrestling action on the 26th, a Saturday in Columbus, Ohio at 8:30. Tickets now on sale at the Ohio Center at all five Columbus Lazarus stores. The 25th, Hiawassee, Georgia, the Georgia Mountain Fairgrounds. Tickets on sale at Shirley Miller's on the Mall. The 24th, Valdosta, Georgia, Mathis Auditorium in Alma, Georgia, Bacon County High School. The 19th, Gadsden, Alabama, the Coliseum, and Carrollton, Georgia, at West Georgia Sports Center. Next Friday, Talladega, Alabama, the high school gym. Next Thursday, Athens, Georgia, J&J Sports Center, and Nashville, Georgia, the elementary school gym. Next Wednesday, Columbus, Georgia. Tuesday, Macon, Georgia. Monday night, Augusta, Georgia. Tomorrow night, Sunday at 8, Marietta, the Cobb County Civic Center. Tomorrow afternoon at 3 in Chattanooga. Tonight, Lakeland, Florida, the Civic Center. And tonight, here's the full card for the big one. 8:30, here's the Omni, right here in Atlanta. Tonight, 8:30, the Omni in Atlanta, a sensational card. Such stars as Brian Blair, Tor Kabata, Bruno Sammartino Jr. in these matches. George Wells and Steve O versus Ernie Ladd and Iron Mike Sharp. Title versus title, Wildfire against the Superstar. Georgia Tag Team Championship, Snook and Gordy against Michael Hayes and Kevin Von Erich. And for the World's Heavyweight Championship, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes against six times former champion Harley Race. That's tonight, 8:30, the Omni, right here in Atlanta.
The young men and women who serve in the Air Force Reserve.
There you see World Heavyweight Wrestling Champion Dusty Rhodes, twice World Heavyweight Champion, out there talking to Bo Young. Bo Young, of course, the son of the former ambassador to the United Nations, Andrew Young, and the two of them here watching the matches today. And, of course, Dusty out here obviously is going to be scouting the match that is upcoming. And that match is, of course, six times World Heavyweight Champion Harley Race going up against Rick Thor. And let's turn it over to our ring announcer for the introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, this event, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Georgia, at 205 pounds, meet Rick Thor. Rick Thor. Ladies and gentlemen, a man of distinction in professional wrestling, a six times former NWA World Heavyweight Champion from Kansas City at 260 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, here's Harley Race. Harley Race.
Harley Race, the only man in the history of professional wrestling to have held the NWA World title on six different occasions, and he would like very, very much to make an unprecedented seventh world championship to his credit. He is, without a doubt, one of the most consummate wrestlers I've ever seen. Look at this rear chancery, now to a side chancery, keeping Thor. Now, Thor tried to move to one side, tried to move around his man. Race, a wary, wary ring general, a top competitor, meets him head on, collar and elbow. Thor with a side headlock on Harley Race, drives Race to one knee. All right, the side headlock by Thor now. Thor in the maroon trunks. Look at Race bringing him up. Belly to back suplex that has Thor to the canvas. And Race punishes Thor. This is the thing about Race. Race is as coldly a methodical wrestler as I've ever seen in my life. He has spent over, basically half of his adult life. He began wrestling at the age of 17. And he has been wrestling over half of his adult life at this point in time. So he has a vast, vast experience on almost any competitor who steps into the ring. Good move by Thor. Hooked that arm very nicely. Race turning into his man. Rick Thor keeping that arm bar on Race. Harley Race, what a program today. Harley Race, six times world heavyweight champion. Dusty Rhodes, the twice world heavyweight champion and current world champion, I might add. The superstar here, Ernie the Cat Ladd, an all-time great in professional wrestling. Beautiful salto. A lot of people call that a variation of a gut wrench. Well executed by Race. So no matter where you might be living, be it Des Moines, Iowa, Seattle, Washington, just no matter where you live, if you think it's exciting here on television, get out and see it live and in person, I can assure you. It's just twice as exciting. Beautiful double underhook that time by Race. Got to give Thor a lot of credit. He is a game competitor. Put up with a lot of punishment. A high knee lift that put Thor through that second rope and out onto the concrete outside the ring. Thor, young, agile. Moving back up on that ring rope and Race again. More punishment, and once again, Thor to the outside and onto the concrete floor. Race utilizing that top ring rope, and the referee, George Scott Jr., watching carefully now as Race brings him up for that vertical souplet. Thor tried to get that back stretched out. It is all over. It is all over. That's the thing about Race. He is such a devastating competitor and keeps himself in just tremendous physical shape. And so the winner, six times world heavyweight champion, Harley Race. This is the trophy that will be awarded to the wrestler who gets the most votes in the most popular wrestling contest, most popular wrestler contest next week. So by all means, do send in your vote during this next coming week. Let me take a moment right now to talk to the superstar. Here's a man who enjoys perhaps one of the most feared reputations in professional wrestling.
There seems to be a lot of commotion here. These people seem to be wanting Tommy Rich. I see that Dusty Rhodes has showed his face again. You've got everybody here. Harley Race, Ric Flair is even here. Wrestling number two, George Wells, Steve-O. All these individuals seem to make their appearance right here because they know that this is the toughest competition. And I want Tommy Rich and I want all these fellas to pay attention, because when I get in this ring, I'm going to show them what I'm going to do. And anybody who wants to put up their championship belts or put up their big egos or their reputations, all they got to do, they don't have to run around and hide and search for me. I'm right here, and I'm not going to leave anytime.
Well, I must admit, of course, you've always been a very, very active competitor, and I've never seen you backing down from any challenges. So obviously what this man has just said is certainly the truth. I would like to point out, however, that tonight in the Omni, of course, title versus title.
See, what understanding. I'm putting up this belt, Tommy Rich. Now, you've been a very, very lucky man. But this evening, right here in the Omni, I am going to lose my cool. I'm going to lose my control for a short period of time, maybe 1 hour, because I'm coming out after you. I am not going to be embarrassed. I am not going to walk out of that arena, that Coliseum in the Omni, without your belt. You have put me in a corner. You have backed me up against the wall, and you have been very, very lucky and very, very smug the last few weeks. You want this championship belt? I want your belt. You want to take this mask off? Well, come on, Tommy Rich. I'll be in the Omni. I'll be right across the ring from you. And it's going to be you and I. And believe me, Tommy, I'm telling you,
I'm going to take your championship belt away from you.
Waiting now to see the superstar in action. He's going up against Curtis Austin. And this, of course, will be one fall also. Superstar. National heavyweight champion, removing his outer garment now, getting set to see action now. Let me tell you something. He's facing quite a man in Curtis Austin. Superstar has him up against the ropes. Caught him with a headbutt coming off the ropes. Snap there that takes Austin to the canvas. Superstar. Another snap there that takes Austin back to the canvas. All right, keeping a rear chin lock on him. Austin trying to use that elbow effectively, unable to do so, and now Superstar. Those tremendous forearm smashes across the back, a double thrust into the chest that puts Austin back to the canvas. And Austin smashed into that far turnbuckle. Austin caught again. And Austin in a lot of trouble out here as Superstar has just unleashed everything he's got on him. Full slam by Superstar. Again, Superstar with a full body slam. Austin in a lot of trouble. Austin hurtled through those ropes, caught his head on that steel bar on the ring apron itself, and Austin has some problems now. And that had to scramble him pretty badly. He caught him that time. He's got the cobra hold. He's got the cobra. And Austin is completely and thoroughly demolished by the superstar using that cobra hold. And so your victor, is the superstar. Well, we have a physician looking after Curtis Austin at this particular time after his match with the superstar. Austin, injured right now. I want to take a moment to talk to a fellow by the name of Tommy Wildfire Rich, former world heavyweight champion, currently the Georgia heavyweight champion.
Well, thank you very much, Gordon. You know, it seems like there's a whole lot of things going on here in Georgia. You know, the Bulldogs is on top, the Falcons is on top, and Georgia Championship Wrestling's got a whole lot of excitement going on. I'm just glad to be a part of it.
Listen, Mr. Big Mouth, I hope you are watching. I hope that guy was your friend, because that's what's in store for you. You're crying and complaining about me putting up this championship belt, and you're walking around telling everybody that you're going to take this mask off. I want to see you do it, Big Mouth.
The question is, though, you know what it amounts to, is the last two times at the Omni, I whipped you. I beat you. So you wanted another shot at the Georgia belt. The only way I'd do it is if you put your title on the line.
Yeah, listen. Well, it's on the line. It's on the line tonight at the Omni, and gentlemen, I'm going to say this. If you both want to stay here, I want it to stop right here.
Listen, don't give me any orders, and don't you give me any orders.
Because I'm going to come out.
I'm going to take this man right here. You've been very, very lucky, Tommy Rich. Well, I'm going to shove this belt down your throat, and I'm going to take the Georgia belt right away from you. And you're not going to be able to do anything about it.
You know, to begin with, this is my time.
Get your fingers out of my chest.
Well, this is my time. And tonight, we're just going to find out how bad you are. And we just might see who you are. Because if I get the chance, that's exactly right. I'm going to pull that mask off your face.
You're a lot of hot air, you man. A lot of hot air. And tonight, you
it's
going to
be
belt,
a whole lot hotter tonight.
You want the mask, too.
Yeah, I want
we'll
the mask.
See.
Gentlemen, please, I'm going to say this. Let's go to the ring.
Tonight, 8:30, the Omni in Atlanta, a sensational card. Such stars as Brian Blair, Tor Kubota, Bruno Sammartino Jr. in these matches. George Wells and Steve-O versus Ernie Ladd and Iron Mike Sharp. Title versus title, Wildfire against the superstar. Georgia Tag Team Championship. Snook and Gordy against Michael Hayes and Kevin Von Erich. And for the World's Heavyweight Championship, the American Dream Dusty Rhodes against six times former champion Harley Race. That's tonight, 8:30, the Omni, right here in Atlanta.
Australian tag team match, and Ernie the Cat Lad stepping over that top rope, offering to shake hands now. We got Ron Haven and Jerry Gray out against Ernie Ladd and Iron Mike Sharp. And Ernie the Cat Ladd, just a massive individual. 5 years all-pro in professional football, and look at the strength of this man. He came out of Grambling College at the same time Charlie Cook graduated. Seven of the 11 graduating seniors on the football team were drafted into the NFL, and that gives you an idea of the kind of a football team and the kind of athletes that Grambling has produced over the years. Ernie the Cat Ladd, a legendary individual. 6'7", over 300 pounds, and he threw him like a sack of meal. Ernie Ladd smashing his opponent into the knee of Iron Mike Sharp. Iron Mike Sharp. Out there issuing more and more punishment, and this man would do wise, and he did wise, by tagging up. Side headlock by Iron Mike Sharp. Sharp smashing his opponent into the turnbuckles, and now brings him off the ropes once again. Tag is made. Ernie Ladd puts that size 16 right over the heart of his man, and then snapmares him to the canvas. Ladd and Andre the Giant are the only two wrestlers that I see just step right over the top rope. Ernie the Cat Ladd has a well-deserved reputation, and you put him with a man like Iron Mike Sharp, and you've got one of the toughest tag team duos I've ever seen. What competition we've had thus far. Ernie Ladd bulls his man back to the ring ropes. Tag is made. Iron Mike Sharp. Wow, and Sharp clubbed him that time coming off the ropes. Hit him like a sledgehammer. Had him a full body slam. And his man's got his problems now. Iron Mike Sharp out of Canada. High backdrop. Sharp. Like Ladd. Big, powerful. Both men with outstanding backgrounds in amateur sports. And Ernie Ladd pressing some extra advantage here. And you'd think with the size and weight advantage that both Sharp and Ladd have, that they would not resort to some of the tactics they use. But you can see the way the back of this man has been completely reddened by the impact of the ropes and the canvas. Ernie Ladd steps in, puts that size 16 right into the chest, right over the heart of his man, and Ladd comes down across his chest. And he knows, when he delivers that to his opponent, it is all over. The winners in this match, Iron Mike Sharp and Ernie the Cat Ladd. We will have a standby match coming up here momentarily. I might just say that, of course, during this past hour, we've had the privilege and the opportunity of talking to the world heavyweight champion, Dusty Rhodes, seeing the former world heavyweight champion, Harley Race, in action, also watching the superstar who is the national heavyweight champion. We have had, indeed, a star-studded hour this far. And we're going to see two more great competitors right now, Jose Medina out of San Juan, Puerto Rico, and Brian Blair. Now, here's a young man that certainly needs to take a careful look at him. Waiting now for that bell to ring and this match to get underway. There it is. Brian Blair He's about 6 foot even. Beautiful fireman carried. Takedown by Brian Blair. Blair, 6 foot even, 228 pounds, going up against Jose Medina. Blair, and I watched this young man in his very, very first pro match. He's out of Tampa, Florida. Went to Tampa Bay Tech and then the University of Louisville. He has his B.S. degree in political science. Carried a 3.1 grade average. Look at that beautiful move by Blair. Went for that guillotine. Medina able to move away from it. Blair, an all-around athlete. He's started in football, wrestling. Look at him set for a salto. Well executed. He was in football, wrestling, baseball, track, and he's done some rodeoing. Blair overhooks the head, so does Jose Medina. We may end up with a stalemate situation here. Back into the turnbuckle. The referee calls for the break. He is just an all-round athlete, but he's facing a very cagey competitor here in Jose Medina. Medina getting that side headlock. Medina keeping that side headlock and may have Blair in a bit of strife here. If I sound just a little high on Brian Blair, it's because he does have such impeccable credentials. Up and over him again, and Blair caught him a good power lift takedown. Another. You notice the one-arm power lift takedown that he uses. It was all-state football and also voted the most valuable wrestler. And although being born in Tampa, Florida, snow skiing is one of his favorite off-time sports. Medina. From San Juan. Blair fires to the midsection, fires again. Medina tries to catch him. Blair bowls him back into the turnbuckle. Medina in wrestling competed in the amateur ranks in the 187-pound class. And he was in 1976, the second in the heavyweight division in parochial and public high schools. So here's a man with quite an experience and background as well. So Brian Blair moving against a very, very capable opponent. Blair keeping that front face lock now. Back into the turnbuckle, Medina. Good clean break here. Obviously a great deal of mutual respect between these two athletes. Medina watching him cautiously now. They have had a chance to test each other. Weight, strength, leverage, balance, and ability. Medina, Medina forearm on the break, and it was Blair. The thing about Brian, he sometimes has a rather short temper, and there's a bolo-like forearm. Takes Medina back to the canvas once again. Blair has him up, and Blair goes into the airplane spin. Back into a back power. Has him. Back power drive to a pinning combination on Jose Medina by Brian Blair. And certainly an outstanding match. There's certainly no question about that. Brian Blair and Jose Medina in a great match indeed. Well, we certainly hope that...
Wait a minute. You hope that you have some class on your interview out here. I'm known as class personified. And I can't know. I don't understand why it took you so long to bring me out here. You got filth that dirty rolls out of a sewer. He hollers his dad was a plumber. Well, he's a plumber as far as I'm concerned. The American nightmare. You got that man with the mask on his face.
I'll tell you what.
You don't
stay tuned. We'll be back in 5 minutes, right after the football scoreboard with my good friend Bob Neal. Bob, it's all yours.
I can run right out of here.
Welcome back to Georgia Championship Wrestling, and the trophy that you see me holding at this particular time is the trophy that will be awarded next week here on Georgia Championship Wrestling to the most popular wrestler. If you have not yet sent in your vote, may I suggest you do so at this time or during the week. All you have to do is send it to Georgia Championship Wrestling, 100 Techwood Drive Northwest, Atlanta, Georgia, 30303. That's 100 Techwood Drive Northwest, Atlanta, Georgia, 30303. Next week, we will be presenting this beautiful trophy to the wrestler who has received the most number of votes. And I might point out that a fellow who is certainly well in front, it's a real close race, but I see he's receiving a tremendous amount of votes as the current Georgia heavyweight champion, Tommy Wildfire Rich.
Thank you very much, Gordon. You know, and that's exactly what it takes. You know, it's good to see a contest like this. And, you know, I hope I do. You know, I hope all the people do send in and vote for me, you know. And I think I stand a pretty good chance. You know, I've been here in Georgia for a while, Gordon. And this is home now. And, you know, the thing is, that's my thing, getting all these people behind me. And it's just good to be here in Georgia.
Well, it's real good to have you here. We can't get too much of a plug here for votes for Tommy or that everybody else will be demanding equal time. But I just want to wish you the very, very best.
Thank you very much, Gordon. Appreciate it.
Tommy Wildfire Rich, the Georgia heavyweight champion, is certainly a prime contender for the most popular wrestler contest. Remember, this is your final week. During the next hour, we're going to be seeing the Georgia Tag Team Champions in action. Also, Ric Flair, Wrestling 2, and many, many more. So by all means, do stay tuned. And right now, here's our ring announcer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this event, one fall, with a 10-minute time limit, this tag team event from Tucson, Arizona, at 245 pounds, here's Bobby Garrett. Bobby Garrett. His team partner from Jacksonville, Florida, at 230 pounds, meet Bob Russell. Bob Russell. Their opponents are the Georgia Tag Team Champions from the Fiji Islands at 245 pounds, Jimmy Superfly Snuka. Snuka. His partner from Chattanooga, Tennessee, at 260 pounds, Terry Gordy. Terry Gordy. Your referee is Nick Patrick. Back with this match right after this.
Terry Gordy moving out first against Russell. Russell in the black trunks. Terry Gordy, massive individual, 6'4", weighs right in the vicinity of 270 pounds. And he's been wrestling for a number of years for his age. Amateur sports, he has specialized in football, baseball, basketball, and wrestling. Notice the partial Nelson there. And this is the thing about Gordy, he'll punish you. He'll get you down on the mat and he'll punish you. Makes the tag with Superfly Snuka. And Snuka, very, very quick hands, quick feet, exceptionally dangerous competitor. Gordy, who of course at one time was part of the team headed up by Michael Hayes, and Russell in a lot of trouble now as Snuka continues to press total advantage on him. Tag is made. Gordy moves back into the ring. Gordy likes to use that pile driver to eliminate his opponents. You can hear the crowd picking up a chant. We want Michael. They're referring, of course, to Michael Hayes. And Bobby Garrett explodes on Terry Gordy. Garrett catches a beautiful drop kick. Gordy into those ropes. Garrett closes in again. Garrett now. As Gordy into that turnbuckle. Gordy ducks to one side. Garrett tore up that knee again. He has got a knee problem with the left leg. Terry Gordy continues to punish Bobby Garrett. And Garrett, back leg trip to the canvas. And it's Gordy again driving that elbow. Notice the way he very quickly Great finds. The that left leg. And that's the thing about Gordy. He has that that killer instinct. He'll go for a wounded member of the body, and that's exactly what he's done here. It'll be interesting to see what Superfly Snuka does, and Snuka right after the same attack on the knee of Bobby Garrett. Garrett out of Phoenix, Arizona. Snuka. Outstanding muscular development. And Garrett's knee is giving him a lot of pain. May not have been the wisest thing for him to get back into competition quite so quickly. Snuka, 6-1, makes the tag with Gordy. Gordy, 6-4. Snuka, 250. Gordy, 270. Couple of cheap shots there by Snuka before the count of three. Or four, rather. And now it is Gordy punishing Garrett again. A very cocky, very, very brash combination, Gordy and Snuka. Garrett back in the center, and again, Gordy attacking that knee and leg. Snuka now continues the attack. Now going after the femoris muscles. Bars the leg. Bars the leg. And it is Garrett who needs very, very desperately to get over and tag up. He needs to get over and Snuka ducked around him. And Garrett hampered by that knee. He tried to bring it up, tried to catch Snuka coming off the rope. Snuka was ahead of him. And Garrett having a real problem with that leg. And again, Gordy, back leg drips and a single leg pickup. Garrett, again, trying to break it up. Garrett in desperation now. Coming away, and Garrett needs to get over and tag. No, sir, Garrett! And what a gutty individual. Tremendous courage on the part of Bobby Garrett. Now, Bob Russell out there. And Russell's had a much-needed respite. Russell went up a drop kick. It was Gordy slipping away from it. Russell came down on his back. That's the thing about the drop kick. It is very dangerous. If you don't make contact, you're in real serious trouble. Gordy now. Bear hug into a full power slam. Makes the tag. Snuka. Caught Russell. Full body weight down across him. And Snuka continues to administer punishment. The Georgia Tag Team Champions are victorious. Snuka and Gordy over Russell and Garrett.
Hey, boy. Big deal, right? Big deal. Beat up somebody that can't fight for themselves, huh? I got something right here that I'll put on you, baby, anytime.
Yeah, you come up here and you put it on me, man.
Well, we've got a challenge working here, and Michael Hayes charging the ring. So is Kevin Von Erich, and we've got a pair sixer going here. A wild free-for-all. Michael Hayes and Kevin Von Erich against Terry Gordy and Superfly Snuka, and Gordy and Snuka moving outside that ring. And we're catching, finally getting things broken up just a little bit here. Gentlemen, I can't say that I blame you for answering the challenge.
Let me tell you something. Any time that you want some of me, I'm going to be around, understand? If I got to be in street clothes to fight you, if I got to be in my trunks to fight you, anytime I get a chance, I'm going to fight you. This is the man, I can't, you know, when I think back on this, this is the man that was the best man at my wedding. This is the man I traveled up and down the road with for 4 years, and it's the same damn man that rubbed my face in the concrete. Now, wait a minute, let me tell you something. There's no way that I'm going to forget it, and there's no way I'm going to let it go by. I don't care how long it takes.
But there's one thing that I'm going to take from you, and you better damn well better believe it, and that's that Georgia strap. And this man right here is going to help me get it, because if it bothers you, then I'm going to do it slowly but surely till I get you all by myself.
Well, it's an understandable anger here on the part of a man whose feelings that he has been betrayed by a man that was, in fact, the best man.
I taught him everything he knew. Betrayed. He ran out when the going got tough because he's nothing but a big baby.
Well, nonetheless, let's just take a moment right now to talk about tonight at the Omni. You and Michael Hayes against Gordian Snuka.
Mr. Soley, I got my wings on, I'm snorting fire, and I'm ready to burn it up tonight.
Well, there you have it, the comments from Kevin Von Erich. It's all going to happen tonight at the Omni. Dusty Rhodes defending that world title. The Georgia Tag Team Championship on the line.
There's a lot of championships on the line. And there's going to be some new people strutting out with some different belts. And we're going to be two of them. Because he can beat the body press, and I done took everything you threw. Now you wear that belt for the last time.
Tonight, 8:30, the Omni in Atlanta, a sensational card. Such stars as Brian Blair, Tor Kubota, Bruno Sammartino Jr. in these matches. George Wells and Steve-O versus Ernie Ladd and Iron Mike Sharp. Title versus title, Wildfire against the Superstar. Georgia Tag Team Championship, Snook and Gordy against Michael Hayes and Kevin Von Erich. And for the World's Heavyweight Championship, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes against six times former champion, Harley Race. That's tonight, 8:30, the Omni, right here in Atlanta.
Well, I'd like to give Mr. Terry Gordy and Superfly Snuka some equal time to respond, if they care to what happened here just moments ago. Mr. Gordy made quite a challenge to Mr. Hayes, and it appeared to me that you and Mr. Snuka were the ones who left the ring.
I believe you're a little prejudiced, man. I think this is what this is all about. You know, you've always heard that Georgia is the hotbed of wrestling. And there's supposed to be all kinds of talent in Georgia. Well, you know, I'm glad that we finally got somebody to go up against us for these titles. You know, Gordon Soley, don't get me wrong. I'm not standing out here saying that we can't be beat. But what I am saying, Gordon Soley, is if anybody out there thinks that they can't beat us, come on and try it. Because we are right here, and we are waiting. And let me tell you something, Gordon Soley. Like I said, tonight in the Omni. You know, Michael Hayes, I'm getting to where I despise every gut in your body, boy. You're nothing but a low-down, lying cadaver. No good dog. Did you see what he brought on TV, Gordon Soley? You know he can stand out here and call Superfly and myself all kinds of names. But Michael Hayes, that's not going to get you these titles, boy. But I'll tell you what it will get you tonight in the Omni. It'll get you a good whooping. And that's just what you're going to get. Boy, don't come thinking that you're going to get your hands on these titles, because this is our bread and butter. This is what puts food on our table. Listen to this. Now see that right there, Gordon Soley? That just goes to right in the Omni, Michael Hayes.
Baby Huey and Terry Gordy and Jimmy Snuka for the Georgia Tag Team Championship.
Baby Huey again.
Here's our ring announcer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this event, one fall with a 10-minute time limit from Jacksonville, Florida, 218 pounds. Here's Mark Watson. Mark Watson. His opponent, ladies and gentlemen, one of pro wrestling's greatest from Minneapolis, Minnesota, the Nature Boy himself at 242 pounds. Here's Ric Flair. Nature Boy Ric Flair.
Ric Flair, who, as I said before about this man, Ric Flair, the Nature Boy, quite an interesting background. Here is a man who was literally born with a silver spoon in his mouth. He got his education in private schools and went on to the University of Minnesota. Flair will circle his man. He is a very flamboyant individual, but let me also state that Ric Flair is a cautious competitor. He does not charge recklessly into a fray with somebody. He was actually born in Memphis, Tennessee, but has spent his entire younger lifetime and until he graduated from the University of Minnesota in Minneapolis. Came out of Wayland Academy, private school. Amateur sports, he was all-state football 2 years and two-time state champion in wrestling. Uses an unusual figure four leg lock. Notice the way he's got the hammer lock on Watson now. Watson out of Jacksonville, Florida. Amateur sports, Watson competed in wrestling, football, baseball, and track. He's out of Edgewood Senior High in Jacksonville. Flair. Good leg dive. Moves up the upper body of Watson, catches that arm. An arm drag and twist. Flair is a man of no wasted motions whatsoever. And although he enjoys, if you will, sort of the fast life, fast living, caught in the midsection, and Flair retaliates very quickly. He keeps himself, as you can see, in tremendous physical condition. Certainly Flair, another top contender for that world heavyweight championship. Good step over, hook into the crotch and a takedown by Flair. Traps the arm. Notice Watson trying to get a bar across the face of Flair. Could not get the leverage from that point. Flair holding a leverage advantage here. Flair continues to dominate the situation. To an inside arm bar now. Now back to a chin lock takedown. Hooked the chin, brought the head back, and of course where the head goes, the body's got to follow. Referee Nick Patrick checking in. Watson gets a foot over the ropes. Collar and elbow once again. Ric Flair now with a side headlock. Back to another side headlock. Reverses that back into a hammerlock. Forward leg pickup. A float over. Sullivan bar on the one arm and now drives the body. Overhooks the one shoulder. Sullivan bar on the arm, and now Watson, good bridge. Good bridge by Watson. Keeps those shoulders off and managed to extricate one arm. And good reversal here by Watson. Came into a lateral press. Flair very quickly powered him off, however. Notice the referee had even left the ring to check on those shoulders very carefully. Watson now. A forearm and knee lift, and now all of a sudden Watson exploding with right hands, catching Flair in the throat and upper chest, and now it is Flair retaliating back. A good chop that puts Watson back to the canvas. Flair now uses that forearm and a chop into the throat as Watson back to the canvas, and you could hear that one reverberate throughout our entire television sports arena here. Flair has him up. Belly to back suplex. And it's Watson. And that surprised me. Watson came out of it before the count of three. Was able to get his shoulders up. And now, Flair, salto. Watson down to the side of his body. And again, Watson comes out of it. I have to admire this young man. Flair, tiring of this. A right hook and then a chop across the throat. And it is Watson hurtled outside the ring onto the concrete. And Watson coming up very slowly indeed. Staggered, trying to get those cobwebs loose, and it is Flair bringing him back inside. Caught him with an elbow off the ropes. Vertical suplex, and this, of course, the very thing that has been so highly successful for so many competitors. And there he goes into that figure four, into the figure four, but from the reverse side, from the opposite side, from the way the figure four is normally applied. And Watson very quickly concedes. Mark Watson concedes. Your victor is the nature boy, Ric Flair. And I might say a well-deserved victory at that. Right now, let me take a couple of moments to talk to a gentleman that I have the utmost respect for, six times world heavyweight champion, looking to gain that title for a seventh time. I'm referring, of course, to Harley Race, a man who at one point in his career, the doctors said, would never walk again and far less would never wrestle again. Went on to become world champion six times, the only man in history to do it.
Let me say this, Gordon. The last time I was in the Omni with Dusty Rhodes, I said to him, if you win, I'll be man enough to shake your hand. And I kept my word. You were there that night. I walked out and shook his hand and congratulated him as becoming world's heavyweight champion.
But that was on June 21st, as a matter of fact.
June 21st. But let me tell you this. When I walked back into the Omni tonight, I'm coming to become the seven-time world's heavyweight champion. There's not a man on the face of this earth. My name will be a legend in wrestling 100 years from today. There's not a man alive that's going to keep that seventh time from happening. I'm going to be the all-time greatest, going right on through history, Rhodes, and I'm just sorry that it's you that are standing in my way, because tonight in that Omni, I'm going to pound on you until your mommy will not even recognize you when they haul you back to Austin, Texas. It's a promise, baby. I promised you the last time. I kept my word. I'm doing it this time.
See you tonight. Well, a lot of things are really coming right down to the wire. First of all, let's talk about the most popular wrestler contest. This is your final week to submit your votes on postcard for the most popular wrestler. Send that to Georgia Championship Wrestling, 100 Techwood Drive, Northwest, Atlanta, Georgia, 30303. That's coming down to the wire. The World Heavyweight Championship is coming down to the wire. In less than an hour, wrestling history could be made. And now here's my good friend, Freddie Miller.
Thanks.
Tor Kamata going up against Bruce Gallagher. Now, Bruce Gallagher will mix it up with anyone, but he's got a problem here when he faces somebody like Tor Kamata. I know Gallagher quite well, and he's a brawler, but I believe this would be the first time that he has faced anybody as large as this Japanese competitor. The great Mephisto standing by me now, watching with a great deal of interest.
You know, I think congratulations are in order for the great Mephisto for bringing in one of the most outstanding talent throughout the universe. You know, Gordon, I can't remember when it has been since a foreigner to the United States has held the world's heavyweight championship. If my memory serves me right, and looking through the record books, I think that Jimmy Landis, the Golden Greek, was the first foreigner to ever come to the United States to maintain that title. And I want to make a prediction here that Tor Kamata will be the second foreigner ever to come to these shores to win that most coveted title.
Interesting observation on the part of the great Mephisto, and of course, Mephisto himself having now adopted the United States as his place of residence. Would obviously, I'm sure, have some specific interest in this field. Kamata using a headbutt very, very effectively to the side of the jaw and to the back of the ear of Gallagher. And Gallagher has just not been able to get up ahead of steam against this man. And Kamata, a difficult subject to control. Mephisto having his problems with him, that gave Gallagher a chance. Gallagher with a forearm, another one. And he's trying to rock this man, Kamata. Tried to set him for a body slam, could not do so, and Kamata, like a sledgehammer, catches him in the back. Stingy! Of course, other foreigners have held the World Heavyweight Championship, but Mephisto's comment was quite correct. To come to the United States, Pat O'Connor is one we certainly should not forget. Pat O'Connor from New Zealand, one of the great, great World Heavyweight Champions, who came here and defended that title. Landis, of course, and a gentleman who has won the title but has never come to the United States because he lost it back before he had an opportunity to get here, the giant Baba. But now it is, and Baba, of course, from Japan, so Kamada is here. Kamada catching those muscles and nerves on the side of the neck of Gallagher. Gallagher has had an interesting and varied career. He'll roll those 18-wheelers. And he'll compete with the very best of them in a brawl or wrestling. But I will say this, that he is facing really some awesome odds in this man, Kamada. He is... I'd be interested, and I'm going to try and find out. But it would not surprise me if this man is quite possibly, because of his girth, quite possibly had some very early sumo training. Notice he keeps pretty generally that wide sumo-like stance and has that exceptionally powerful upper body. Wow! Power slam Gallagher right to the canvas. And a shriek emanating from the mouth of Kamada as he crashed down on Gallagher once again. And Gallagher trapped. And that was definitely, he caught him. A thrust right to the heart. A thrust right to the heart. And that can cause momentary paralysis, unconsciousness. And again, he catches him. And Gallagher in a lot of trouble here, down on the canvas. And Gallagher, at this point, it would seem logical he is unable to defend himself at all. Kamada mercifully moves in with a lateral press, and it is the great Mephisto moving Kamada out of the way. And this match is over. Gallagher defeated by this awesome Japanese, Tor Kamada. I'll tell you what, the fellow with a $1 million smile and a $10,000 gold and diamond studded World Heavyweight Championship belt around his middle is with me right now, Dusty Rhodes.
You know, God, I can't figure out who Harley Race think he fooling, you know. Harley Race be coming out here, be talking real soft. He be talking about, I was a man when I walked up to Dusty Rhodes and shook his hand. He be talking more trash than main men do talk on the streets. You understand? He is talking to the rap master. I was Fantasia before it was customary to be that way. You understand that? I was what was going on before it was customary to be that way. And I was the king. He's a rock and roll when little Richard was running around in tennis shoes. You understand what I'm saying? Talking about being six times, seven times world heavyweight title. That title don't belong to me. I wouldn't have one damn thing if it was not for the people of the state and of the United States of America that drive the American dream to be what he is right now. Can you talk about a struggle? Life is a struggle, Daddy. You sitting out there right now, there's a lot of people can't even get out of a wheelchair. That's a struggle. Harley Race, that's a struggle. There's people that's on Skid Row drinking wine. That's a struggle. But right here is a kid that was digging ditches at 8 years old and now is world's heavyweight champion, and that is a struggle. So tonight in the Omni, in just a few hours, you're going to have a struggle. You're going to meet a struggle. You're going to meet the Rap Master. You're going to meet 260 pounds of screaming, stealing sex appeal, Jack. Struggles are my life. Struggles are part of my father's life. They were part of my mama's life. And they are part of the American way of life. And tonight, the Omni, it's going to be a struggle to take that belt from me and my people.
Right. Wrestling 2 moving out against Rick Benefield right now. And a good clean break by Wrestling 2. Some heavy, heavy comments from the world heavyweight champion, Dusty Rhodes. Quite a man, quite an individual. All right, Benefield has sort of a smug expression on his face. We'll find out how long he stays smug. He's facing one of the great masters in professional wrestling. I'm talking about Wrestling 2. Benefield using those ring ropes to his own advantage, forcing the break. Arm drag and twist by Wrestling 2. Benefield slides over, gets a chance to utilize that ring rope. He's 6'2", 222 pounds. He's out of Salisbury, North Carolina. And it was Benefield catching Wrestling 2 from behind. Caught him from behind and drove that knee into his back. And now Benefield closing in with everything that he's got. Benefield using those forearms now. Now after that mask, ripped away at that mask momentarily of Wrestling 2, Benefield closes in on him once again. Benefield brings him up. A full body slam. And so maybe Mr. Benefield had something to smile rather smugly about. Maybe he thinks he knows. And he's after the mask again of Wrestling 2. And Wrestling 2 explodes to the midsection, one to the top of the head. Wrestling 2 with another forearm. Wrestling 2 continues now to pummel and beat away at Benefield. Wrestling 2 catches him off the ropes. A high backdrop on Benefield. And Benefield missed with a looping right hand. Wrestling 2, belly to back souffle. Benefield coming up very slowly. Wrestling 2 sets. Delivers that high knee lift, that million-dollar knee lift, and that is... Oh, wait a minute. A Japanese arm bar. A Japanese arm bar, and I have not seen that used that often. A Japanese arm bar, and so... Wrestling 2, obviously thoroughly enraged at Benefield's tactics and actions, decided to lay some punishment off. And another side of Wrestling 2 that heretofore has perhaps remained somewhat masked, but it is out in the open now. Wrestling 2 getting retribution on Benefield. He is the victor, Mr. Wrestling number 2. You know, the old cliche is that the cream rises to the top, and certainly if there's a man who's ever risen to the top in professional wrestling, it's a nature boy, Ric Flair, who's with us right now.
Well, Gordon, I thank you very much for those kind words. The preacher's here, isn't he? You know, I was in the back room there, and I heard him come out here. I'm talking about our world champion. Now, I told you, and I told all the people of Georgia, and all the wrestling capitals all over the world, that I was here for competition. Whether it was Rich, whether it was Gordy, whether it was Snooker, whether it was Hayes, whether it was Superstar, or whether or not it was Dusty Rhodes, it made no difference. But let's face it, I'm in a great sport of professional wrestling for the same reason everybody else is. Money and glory. And don't think anything else. Dusty Rhodes, you're the world champion, and I want to be the world champion. You know, unfortunately, I wasn't born a son of a plumber. And I wasn't digging ditches when I was 8 years old. I've always had things the way I wanted them throughout my whole life. If I wanted a big car, I went out and bought it. If I wanted an airplane, I went and bought it. If I wanted the finest clothes money could buy, I went out and bought it. If I wanted this, come here one time. If I wanted this, and I'm going to show you something right here. Come in here, ladies. If I wanted this, Gordon Solie, all I did was snap my fingers. Now, Dusty Rhodes didn't do nothing like that, did he? Ladies and gentlemen, this I've got. The world championship belt I don't have. Tommy Rich, I don't have you yet either. Superstar, I don't have you yet either. And I'm staying in Georgia till all three of you are mine. You understand that? Born with a golden spoon. Used to have and laugh the way he likes it. Anything I want, if I can't buy it, I go out and take it. Think about that, ladies and gentlemen. What Ric Flair wants in the long run, he's going to get. Isn't that right, ladies? Woo! All right.
Yeah. There's not much I'm going to say at this point, except let's go to the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a six-man tag team event. One half of the six-man combination is already in the ring. The other half is on its way. Let's introduce from Milan, Italy, a 241-pound. The big hand might be for those arriving on the scene rather than those already there. Let's introduce a 241 from Milan, Italy, Tony Russo. Russo. His partner, Snake Brown from California, and Alex Reinhoff from Germany. Their opponents, here's Michael Hayes, the original Freebird himself, Kevin Von Erich, and the Georgia champion, Tommy Wildfire Rich.
Okay, a six-man tag team match. Tommy Wildfire Rich, Michael Hayes, and Kevin Von Erich. What a trio. Moving up in this match, some interesting international affiliations here. Italy being represented, Germany, and Pacific Beach in California with Snake Brown. Snake Brown coming off of a knee injury, and talking to him earlier, says he's in fine shape. That's Russo moving out against Tommy Wildfire Rich. And Russo very quickly bowled him back to the ropes, and Wildfire Rich fought his way off. He realizes Russo, probably one of the best infighters, if you will. If he gets a man into those ropes, he does a lot of damage. And Wildfire, aware of this, kept him away from those ropes. Good hip lock takedown by Rich. Well, Mr. Flair, just as flamboyant as always. Interesting individual.
All the people's behind us, and a lot of good things is fixing to start happening.
They are indeed. Thank you so very much. The Georgia heavyweight champion, Tommy Wildfire Rich. And that's all the time we have for this week.
A lot of pretty ladies out here today.
Amen to that, brother. Till next week, Gordon Solie saying so long from the Peach State of Georgia.
Coming up next.